experiential history, which in part is at the core of the rooted wisdom experience, is to put people on the physical landscape and allow them to connect in a tangible way with the environment and the history which played out in that environment. Well, what does that have to do with the Underground Railroad, you might ask? The relationship between Adkins and this pivotal point in history is the space between slavery and the dream of freedom. When you're here at Adkins, you get a little window into the scale of it all. Being on the landscape, it leaves in one's mind what it must have been like to be on that journey day after day after day. For instance, the sweet gum produces this pod, which is thorny and a little uncomfortable to the touch. So as I do tours here at Adkins, I ask people to pick up that pod and hold it in their hand, to imagine being barefoot, running across the landscape, and imagine what it would feel like stepping on something like this, or the bare ground, or over stones, or fording streams. These are some of the elements that are used in experiential history. So we use objects to help tell the story, and we turn first to the object or the resource. With Adkins, it's an arboretum. It's the landscape, it's the trees. What has that landscape seen? What stories would those trees tell if they could speak to us? Adkins provides the space for people to walk and explore and soak in the nature around them. And in that space, one finds contemplation. And so this story, which was one of people traveling many miles seeking freedom, is perfectly married to the landscape here and gives us an opportunity to think and reflect on the journey that in one way brought us all here, the journey of the Underground Railroad.